Hi, hello, good day to my subscribers and to my friends over at Facebook. No, today I will be obliging a certain request from a friend, from a colleague, from a kakards, in a way, to one of my kahabis, sa NBA cardboard collecting, no, sports card collecting, si Leandro Centillas. No, he was asking me to feature or make a spotlight, cardboard spotlight on Reggie Miller, and I think I should oblige naman, no? So we will be spotlighting on the cardboards that I have of Reggie Miller, no? Okay? So didiscussin natin kung bakit hindi na masyadong gagalaw yung cards nito, but it's a good investment, in a way, quote-unquote investment. I wouldn't say it's an investment because they really won't go up anymore, but at least stable yung mga cards nila. So there, no, if you could get them low, you could sell them as well, as high, higher than what you bought them for, no, if ever you want to sell them. He collects Reggie Miller mostly, and he has a group, a Philippine-based group na Reggie Miller for cardboard collectors of Reggie Miller, no. Also for fans of Reggie Miller for that matter, no. But it's a Philippine-based group, no. Ngayon well, papakita ko din sa inyo yung bagong binili ko na iPhone 13 na Pro Max. Papakita ko lang saglit before I show my Reggie Miller collection. It's a very very small collection. Kaya ako papakita yung iPhone 13 because maganda yung nagawa na, talagang maganda rin pala pag may line ka for certain networks, no. I'm using Smart actually. So malaki kasi ang discount at saka at least yung Pro Max I'll be able to use it for vlogging kasi mas malinaw talaga compared to what I am using right now, which is the iPhone 11. iPhone 11 lang to. This will be my last vlog using this phone actually, and I'm going to sell this in the long run para maging pera, no, kasi sayang lang ang at least may value pa habang may value yung iPhone 11 for that matter. So let's go. Ang uunahin ko muna is the iPhone 13 before the Reggie Miller cards, no. So sandaling-sandali lang yon, papakita ko lang saglit, and wala naman akong hindi naman ako tiga Smart, so sasabihin ko lang yung the benefits of having a line, no, when you have it renewed, no. Yung iba sa inyo alam na yan eh, but if you have enough finances to do so, mas maganda talaga, so that mas makakatipid kayo in a way, no. So let's go and let's look at my iPhone 13 Pro Max, the new one, and also it's not an unboxing, ha, so at saka itong mga Reggie Miller cards ko. Let's go. So here goes, guys, no? As I've mentioned, ang uunahin natin is the iPhone 13, no. I shall be discussing the Smart program, but I'm not affiliated with Smart, ha. I'm just discussing it for my viewers to see the benefits of having a line, no. So I bought this phone yesterday. Yesterday was February 1 and it was already alert level 2. So I was with my son, no. Ayan na nakalagay, iPhone 13 Pro Max Silver 128GB. 6 years old lang yun eh. So, nilabas namin siya yesterday. So, silver yan. Ito yung itsura ng phone. No, ayan. Ayan siya. Ayan. So, very responsive siya, guys. And maganda talaga yung camera niya. As advertised by Apple, no? So, ayan yung camera. Pro Max to, guys. So, yun, no? I bought this for 47,300. That's what I want to discuss with you. Ang original price nito is about 67 or 70,000 pesos, I think, no, if I'm not mistaken. So malaki-laki rin yung binigay na discount ng Smart with their retention program. So, 'di ba? So okay 'yun kasi I had a line with them since for 2 years already with an iPhone 11 included, no, which I am using right now that I'm going to sell in a few days or weeks, no. So, kasi para lang mabawi rin yung gastos dito. I will be using this for vlogging kasi. That's why I really used the Pro Max. I really wanted the Pro Max. Kasi may nagsabi sa akin, si RJ Arroyo actually, na si GG Easy na mag-Pro Max ka. Sabi niya para mas maganda yung resolution ng camera. So, ayun, no? So, I decided to buy it, no, for 47,300 cash out, no. Kinash ko na lang buo, hindi ko na ginawang monthly installment, although pwede rin, no. So yun ang benefits ng having a line. Even though I'm paying for 1,500, naka-tie up siya for 2 years, no. But naka-subscription ka, so you have a unlimited text to all networks, unlimited calls to Smart and Sun networks, and then 100 free minutes of Globe usage, you know. Pwede kang tumawag sa Globe or sa landlines, no. And also, meron kang 10 gig na internet use, free of use, no. Pwede na, kasi I was paying for 1,800 for internet, for mobile internet, and then 300 for monthly usage noon nung nakaline ako sa Sun, no. So kung isipin niyo, it's the same. I was paying for 1,200 per month. Ito 1,500. So konti lang ang dinagdag mo, nakakuha ka pa nito. At saka mas maganda yung internet niya than having a mobile internet. Yung ano, yung maliit na ganun. Tapos before I forget, wala na talaga siyang adapter. So since sa iPhone 11, wala na talaga ang adapter ang Apple, no, mga Apple iPhones. So you have to buy a separate adapter. Before, okay lang kasi the adapter at that time can still be used, yung mga lumang adapters nila, no. Ang problema ngayon, iba na yung kable, yung cable na binibigay ng Smart. So you have to buy this, no. So this is worth 800 pesos. I don't know if that was okay, no. Comment down below na lang if I was overpriced, no. So, ayan, nilagyan ko na pala ng casing to, guys, no? Hindi ganyan na itsura niya. Katanggalin ko na nga lang din para maipakita sa inyo. Ayan yung itsura niya. Nawalang casing. Ayan. So, dangkan yung wallpaper ko. So, there you go, no? Balik ko lang. Ayan. Alright, so ngayon, let's discuss about Reggie Miller, which is the real reason why we made the vlog, no? So again, no, I'm obliging the request of Landro Santillas, no, na i-feature daw yung kanyang favorite player, which is Reggie Miller. So fortunately, I have a few cards of him, no, that I'd like to show off. And then let's discuss about his cards future. Kung may future pa ang cards si Reggie Miller or wala na. So, ito yung kanyang rookie card, no? Reggie Miller was drafted in 1987, 11th overall, no? He ended his career with Indiana as well in 2005, you know? I just like to put it there. Ito yung kanyang likod ng kanyang rookie card. This is his only rookie card, no? So, this is a must-have for Reggie Miller collectors, no? Yan lang ang rookie card niya from Fleer, no? My other cards of him are these, no? I'd like to show you yung isa sa mga cheap cards na gustong-gusto ko sa kanya. Not that one. This one. Ito, no? Yung sharpshooter cards niya. Sharpshooters. I don't know kung ito na lahat yon. But this was released in 94-95. In 1994-95 from Fleer. Ayun na nakalagay, oh. Sharpshooters. Kita ba? Ayun na. Kita ba? Ayun. Tapos, ito naman from Fleer Tradition. 2000 to 2001. He's even being guarded by Jason Kidd. Ayan. Kasi sharpshooter si Reggie Miller. So, ang ganda ng insert. Talagang bagay sa kanya, no? The other inserts that I'd like to show off are these, no? Konti lang talaga ang Reggie Miller cards ko, eh. So, ito yung isa, no? Very unique. That's why I wanna show this to you. But it's also cheap, no? This came from Finest. Tops Finest in 1999 to 2000. Kung titingnan ninyo, mababasa ninyo, it stated na remove protective mask, touch circles to activate thermal ink. So there's a thermal ink here that you could touch and then it turns black. And then if you touch it again, it could turn brighter or medyo clearer. So that you could see the stats, although it doesn't really work anymore. So you have to take this off as well. Di ko na tinanggal. Kasi I pack pulled this back in the day in 1998. So I never did pa remove this protective mask, no. Kaso maganda, that's why I want to show this to you, is that nakaka-miss. So I feel nostalgic when I see these cards. Kasi especially these kinds of cards because they're unique, no? I haven't seen a unique card from any manufacturer since after the 90s, to be honest with you. I haven't seen anyone make one na ganitong klase. Panini, Upper Deck, they haven't really done anything unique except for autographs. Ayun, ano? So that's very cheap. I just want to show it off to you. Ito yung kanyang Ionix card. Sky Ionix ang tawag dito from 1999 to 2000. Ay, sorry, 1998-1999. Ionix, Upper Deck, Ionix, Sky Ionix. Or is it 99-2000 nga? If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it's 99-2000. I think so, ano? If I'm not, I know, it's a Vince Carter year, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong na lang. But 90s card to. Ionix, alright? That's seeded at 2 per case or 1 per case? Ito 1 per case talaga. I think, Vortex. Kasi sobrang dami kong nabuksan na packs ito, wala akong nakuha ni isa. Vortex of Reggie Miller, 1996 to 1997. Alright, ayan ang likod. Ano to, medyo embossed siya. It's pretty cool. I have the whole set. So, I have the Jordan. I have the Grant Hill that I wasn't able to show you dun sa Grant Hill vlog ko. Ito ang ang pinaka-importanteng card ko ng Reggie Miller. It's very memorable. It's very nostalgic. It has sentimental value for me. Although it's really cheap, I don't think you would be able to sell this for 200 pesos even, no? It's an Electric Court Gold from Upper Deck 1994 to 1995. The reason why it's so nostalgic for me or memorable for me is because this is the first pack pulled insert, major insert, no, na major rare, quote-unquote rare, that I ever pulled in my life. 1994, I was just 20 years old when I pulled this. I was into Marvel cards at that time. I decided to make a pass on several basketball cards noon dun sa Harrison Plaza shop of a lady, no, babae ang may-ari noon eh. I don't know kung alam niyo 'yon. So ito yung na-pull ko. So it was very memorable because a lot of people who were there actually were mesmerized that I was able to pack pull this, no. This 1:24 or 1 per box insert or parallel in just 3 packs. And nakakuha pa ako ng ibang inserts kasi ito yung first na nakuha ko talaga from that box. So, they actually clapped. So, doon ako, isa sa mga reasons kung ba't ako nag-start mag-basketball is because of Reggie Miller. mag-basketball cards is because of Reggie Miller. But, hindi naman. So, to be honest with you, hindi. But, I really wanted to delve into NBA cards kasi parang feeling ko at that time mas magandang mag-basketball cards or sports cards than Marvel, no? Kasi hindi mawawala ang basketball. Well, in any case, no, ito naman yung isa kong gusto kong pakita is from Topps Finest 1999 to 2000 off the meter. The gold number 2/100. Ang nasa likod is Allen Houston. The nice thing about this for Reggie Miller collectors is that ang gold niya is ang front is the gold and on the front is Reggie Miller. So, then having Allen Houston at the back, this is better, di ba? So, there you go. Mataas to ng konti, but I just bought this cheap. I don't know from whom, but definitely got this cheap. I don't think that I even spent 1,000 for this. How many decades na rin naman kasi yun. So, ayan, no? Since I bought it. So, it's number 200, number 50 of 100. No? So, iwan na lang natin dyan. So, last but not the least is my autograph of Reggie Miller that I bought for 2 to 3,000 pesos or $60 to, yeah, $40 to $60 in 2005 or 2006 from, I still remember, from Mang Bernie Aspiren. So, shout out to you, sir. No? Ang tagal na natin magkakilala. So, sa inyo galing to. So, it's from SP Signature Edition 2003-2004. So, it's the LeBron James sweepstakes year, no? So, ayan, no? At this time, Reggie Miller hasn't really signed a lot of cards yet. So medyo mataas yung cards niya at the time. So I think, although nag-taper down na yung mga cards ni Reggie Miller, yung mga autographs niya, because he has signed for Panini, marami na rin siya napirmahan for Panini, but he is still highly collected because of the fact that he's a legend. His autographs are still highly collected. Hindi yung inserts, but yung autographs niya. Kasi yung iba talagang gusto kahit na magkaroon na ng isa. So I think, dahil pre-Panini to, a lot of people are fond of getting pre-Panini cards from Upper Deck, from Topps, from Fleer. Mataas siya than the Paninis, the usual Panini cards that we have, no? I'm not talking about the patches, ha? I'm just talking about the usual stuff that from Panini. I think this could still be sold for 5,000 and above, no? $100 and up. So basically, yun ang mga cards ko ni Reggie Miller ko, konti lang, pasensya na. So, ang akin lang, no? For those who are asking, for those who are not collecting NBA cards, or for those who are still are newbies, no? Pwede ba kayong mangolekta ng mga ganitong klaseng players who are established? Larry Bird, Magic Johnson, Jason Kidd, and Fernie Hardaway, Grant Hill? Yes. No? Basically, yes. Kasi mas wala kang risk dito sa mga players na to. The only problem with these kinds of cards is that, with these kinds of players is that, hindi niya gaanong tataas ang mga cards nila unless something drastic happens to them. If something happens to Reggie Miller, wag naman sana, no? Syempre, yung mga autographs niya would balloon. Kaso yung mga ganitong klaseng cards, I don't think that they really would still go up that much, no? Kasi established na nga yung players. Players like Duncan, like Shaquille, yung iba tumaas na lang during the pandemic, but nobody expected that to happen talaga. So ito, tumaas na rin ng konti yung mga cards si Reggie Miller during the pandemic, but right now, they have already tapered down a bit. But you could still sell them as long as you got them low. So, yung mga iba na gustong bumili na Reggie Millers and want to invest on him, syempre, bibili ka pa rin ng mababang presyo if you wanna invest, no? If you wanna collect, then just collect him, no? Kasi mas walang risk to. So, nag-enjoy ka na sa cards and then you could actually sell, you enjoyed your collection and if you really need the money, you could actually sell them off, no? So, wala, hindi na nga lang talaga siya quote-unquote investment, but it's a collector's perspective, no? In that sense, no? So, ayun, no, yung mga established players, pwede pa naman talagang kolektahin. Wala namang problema doon. It's just that, don't expect to, na tataas siya compared to the Ja Morant sa Zion Williamson's of the world. Yung mga yon, tataas yon kung magaling yung player. Kasi naglalaro pa. Ito, hindi na naglalaro eh. So, di ba? But yung risk dito, wala na. Unlike with Ja Morant or Zion Williamson for that matter, or LaMelo Ball, once they get injured or they don't win anything, no, an award or even what you call this, a championship, maaaring bumaba ang cards nila kasi uunti ang kanilang ang magiging interesado sa ang demand sa cards nila. Tandaan niyo, ang cards, no, just like any collectibles, are based on supply and demand. The prices are always dependent on supply and demand. Actually, in demand talaga. Sa demand talaga nagbe-base dyan. Kung talaga marami may gustong kumuha, bakit hindi tataas ang cards ng isang player, no? So ito, very highly collected pa rin si Reggie Miller, especially his autographs. So, but not the inserts that much, no? Hindi masyado. But as I have mentioned kanina, meron mga nangungulekta na pa rin kay Reggie Miller worldwide and even in the Philippines, no? There you go. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you learned something from the vlog. Alright? So, for those who haven't subscribed yet, please do so, no? And please hit the notification bell so that you would be notified whenever I have new vlogs for you to watch, no? So, I hope you enjoyed it and this vlog. And please do watch my other vlogs in the coming days and yung mga iba kong vlogs down below, yung mga iba kong naging vlog. So, comment down below kung meron kayong gustong player na i-feature or i-spotlight. So, there you go. So, again, 2 thumbs up, guys, and stay safe. And, ano tawag mo rito? Maging mabait kayo. Hindi, joke lang. So, thank you very much again, and hope to see you soon in my next vlogs. Thank you very much.